Across the road from the church where he was married, Gordon Allan and his supporters begin 12 miles of cycling. The swimming is done. After comes the walking. Three pastimes he and his wife enjoyed together.
I'm doing it to celebrate my 40th wedding anniversary. I guess my approach since I lost Sally is to sort of try and turn these milestone anniversaries into sort of a positive memory. We had started talking about our 40th wedding anniversary, and you know, I guess we might have been on a holiday to Vietnam or, you know, camper vanning in Scotland or something. So it's not exactly as it was planned, but you know, it is really nice to think, you know, that Sally's still out there helping people. That's the way, I guess, that I get comfort, I think.
What's the spirit like among the team here?
Oh, very good. Yeah, very good. Very enthusiastic and positive. Taking part in a triathlon is a fantastic way to, obviously, if you're suffering from mental health, exercise and getting out in the fresh air, meeting people, it's all kind of very positive things to help you with any mental health issues that you've got out there.
Sally hadn't told her family she was unwell. Since her death, they have campaigned to raise awareness of the issue. Money made from the triathlon will go to the mental health charity Mind, as well as the Sally Allan Fund, to help deliver presentations.
Sally spent her life helping others. I mean, she did that too much. She didn't take care of herself. And that's one of the things about mental health, is at times you do have to be selfish. But Sally loved helping other people. And therefore, yeah, what better legacy than to sort of use her name and her story to go around and help others.
It's a legacy being kept alive in many different ways on a day of huge significance. Jonny Blair, ITV News, Ponteland.